HVAC is heating, ventilating, and air conditioning, and R stands for refrigeration.
You don't realize you don't have air conditioning until it's gone.
Well, HVAC is everywhere. It's the systems that keep our buildings and our houses comfortable.
It's in our classrooms, it's in buildings, it's in grocery stores, it's in the winery and brewery business.
A lot of what we do here is design, build, test, and that's exactly what we learned at Cal Poly. Everything we do at Cal Poly in the engineering department involved elements of design, hands-on building, and testing at the end to see if it was done correctly.
The refrigeration class that I'm taking, I'm applying all of the math that I've learned before, and we're making a miniature ice rink, and that's just really cool to be able to actually put my hands on this and say, I built this.
There's a really good mix of doing a lot of work in the office as well as out in the field. See the things that we've designed on paper on the computer come to life.
You're not stuck at a desk every day. You're not staring at a 3D animation of what you're building. You actually get to go to the job site and see it in person.
So we're here at the Firestone Walker Brewery.
We use heating and cooling systems all over this place for everything you can imagine. I mean, from cooling the offices to cooling the warehouse to cooling the beer, heating the beer, you name it, we use all of it.
We're here at Kenneth Volk Vineyards. In wine production and wineries, a huge amount of air conditioning and refrigeration is utilized. As wine is made and the processing and fermenting of wine, it has to be chilled to remove the heat of fermentation, but also during the long aging process, it has to be stored in barrel rooms that require a very specific cool temperature.
There are lots of opportunities to work on a lot of great projects in this industry. We have graduates that have gone on to work at Disney and design rides in terms of the air conditioning systems behind the scene.
Even if you're on the fence about what you're really looking into going into at Cal Poly, mechanical engineering, here's an opportunity to meet a bunch of cool people that are interested in similar passions. I can't see a reason why not to get involved.
I feel if more people knew about this concentration, they would actually be interested in it because it is such a profitable industry.
There's a lot that you can do with an HVAC degree. I'm personally going into designing, so I'm going to design systems. But there's also sales, so if you're a more personable engineer, you can go and you can talk with people and you can design systems and sell them to the people.
Whether you're working inside or whether you're working outside, if you're working for a design firm or you're working for a mechanical contractor, all of those great jobs exist, and they exist in every city across the U.S.
Air conditioning consumes roughly 60% of the world's electricity.
The largest consumer of energy in the world or energy that's consumed in buildings in those buildings, the largest consumer of energy within the buildings is the HVAC systems.
We're building environments that people live and work in hospitals people are getting operated in.
And we need young, bright minds to take on this challenge, to make the buildings of the future.